Nowadays, SSD is more popular hard drive cause it makes your PC or laptops 10 times faster and reliable and takes the performance to the next level. In the field of SSD, before of Western Digital, Corsair, SanDisk or Kingston, Samsung's name is more popular for its Evo series SSD, including its Pro series SSD 2 for extreme performance. So here in my hand, this is the Samsung Evo 860 250GB SSD. Hey everyone, you are watching SanDisk & Das. I am your tech guy and this video is all about unbox, review and installation. So keep watching this video till end, and if you are new, please consider subscribing my channel and tap the bell icon beside of it not to miss any upload notification from me. So let's get into this video. Here, Samsung Evo 860 SSD, which is a new upgraded version of the previous most popular Evo 850 series 256GB model. And this comes in black box with Samsung SSD type image and Samsung branding logo on it. Also written the series name and capacity on it. This SSD is powered by vertical NAND technology with SATA 6Gbps interface, and this is the SSD that makes the really difference. Yes. And on the back side of the box, there's nothing special without as it is being a retail unit, so a retail sticker and 5 years of Samsung limited warranty. This SSD is made by Samsung China Semiconductor in China and has been imported by Samsung India. Also make sure there are BW written with the SSD model to ensure it is an Indian original Samsung SSD model, which you can see at my retail unit. The retail price is near about Rs 6000, which you can buy on Amazon or Flipkart through my below link in video description to help my channel if you wish to buy. So let's cut the company's box seal. Inside in black plastic container, it comes two things. One is the user guide. Here's the user manual book in which we're generally not interested to read, but don't be lazy. Read it before we start to install the drive. And next, this is our main guest. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, please give a huge round of applause. Okay. Again, wow. This is so small in size, as I expect it even smaller than my plum, and 10 cm in total length. On the black color, this is the Samsung branding logo and Evo series indication with gray square logo. And next on the side, this is the SATA 6Gbps connection and SATA power connecting port. Below there are 4 screw holes along with 4 sides to install in any direction, horizontal or vertical. And in the box, Samsung has not provided any screw to mount or SATA cable. All those you need to arrange yourself under 50 bucks. Below there are again some unique informations about this SSD. So this SSD has extreme performance. This SSD has 550 MB sequential read and 520 MB sequential write speed. It has also compatibility with the SATA 3Gbps and SATA 1.5Gbps interface, in which it limits the maximum potential, but can notice a huge speed difference than any culprit movable mechanical hard disk, which really slows down your system, whatsoever your processor is, either 8th generation Core i3, Core i5, Core i9 or Celeron dual core. So this SSD is perfect for your PC or laptop. In case of laptop, you can also install the newly designed SATA M.2 NVMe SSD too. So Samsung used vertical 4th generation 3D 64 layer VNAND flash, which is able to deliver highest performance at low queue depths. Samsung outfitted the A60 series with a new MGX controller that supports lower DDR4 memory, which accomplished by reducing the input voltage from 3.3 volts to just 2.5 volts and the program time to 500 microseconds, which is 1.5x faster than the previous generation model, you know. And so this SSD has more error free faster data controlling option, which really make it differ from the other to be the best SSD, especially for the gamers and people who do editing for faster response. Only Samsung is the oldest company to make the best quality SSD since so many years, you know. And by the way, as per Samsung, its weight is only 50 grams. And this SSD also have varieties of 512 gigs, 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte and 4 terabyte. So I have a desktop PC with G41 motherboard, Core2 Duo CPU and 4GB EVGA DDR3 RAM, which have mechanical 120GB PATA hard drive that extremely slows down my PC. And as it has 4 onboard SATA port, then I thought, why not just to give a speed boost by this Samsung SSD. Though my motherboard has maximum SATA 3GBps interface, which will limit my SSD's max potential performance, but it will give a really water and sky speed difference. Yes, and here you can see my PC cabinet, which has been unplugged from everything and ready to be installed to get a speed boost. Already my eyeball PC cabinet has bracket option, but I will install it on side horizontally without any bracket. So here is my Samsung Evo 860 SSD drive, which you can see, and this is the SATA 6GBps cable which I have got from my friend. Now just connect one end of the SATA cable to the SATA connector port of SSD and make sure the pin position of the connectors at the exact direction with the SSD, and the other side of SATA cable will be connected to one of the SATA port on the motherboard. And on the SATA power connector, just connect the SATA power cable which you may have at your SMPS or power supply unit at the cabinet. If you don't have any SATA power cable, then you can get this SATA power connector converter from any local store or online store. And this is the SATA power connector, which looks like. Okay, so now my power cable is connected to the SSD drive and ready to be mounted on the cabinet's wall. So first mount it and then plug the SATA cable to the motherboard SATA port. Here also be careful about the pin direction while plugging in the SATA port, otherwise it can damage the SATA port. And this is all ready to install the OS in it, and it will be a fresh copy installation of OS in the SSD drive. And as it is being only 50 gram, and in spite of having cabinet inbuilt bracket option in my eyeball cabinet, I have attached horizontally with the cabinet's bracket side by side with two screw. And don't worry, it is so perfect and has no movable part inside the SSD to produce vibrate. So here, don't worry, no chance to fall off, and hence you don't need to buy any extra bracket. Now inside my computer, you can see these are the my three old 120 gigs hard drives, which is usable at 111 gigs and is in the three partitions C, D and E drive. So before you start installing OS, you don't need to remove your existing mechanical hard drive from your system. As usual, just insert the OS DVD into the DVD drive or USB bootable flash drive into the USB 3.0 in case you don't have any DVD ROM. Then just restart the computer or system, and as soon as keep pressing the delete button until the BIOS menu appearing on your screen. After next, inside the BIOS menu, go to the advanced BIOS feature. From there, go to hard disk drive and make sure Samsung SSD is your first hard disk drive listed on the option, and select the mechanical hard drive as second. Come back and go to boot device priority. Then select the DVD ROM or flash drive, that means your pen drive, which you are using to install as your first boot device. And Samsung SSD is a second boot device to tell the computer that Samsung SSD is the only primary hard drive to install the system in it. Okay. So then come back and go to integrated peripherals and select the IDE configuration. Inside the configuration menu, select the SATA mode as IDE. Cause in case you are using mechanical hard drive or DVD ROM with same controller with SSD, so it is the best option for SSD to communicate each other when it is in IDE mode. Otherwise, if you select the AHCI mode, then it may not work with other on same controller, cause AHCI is advanced host controller which may not supported by other devices like mechanical hard drives or DVD ROM. Okay, then come back and save and exit to save the settings you have changed. Now, as soon as the computer restart and logo will appear, continuously keep pressing the F12 button on your keyboard until the boot device menu appearing. After then, select the DVD-ROM or USB flash drive which you are using. In case mine, I am using the DVD drive, and then your OS installation will be automatically start. First, select the language, and in drive option, select the SSD as system drive and format the existing partitions of the mechanical hard drives, that is C, D, and E, which is existing right now. Totally format those drives to avoid conflict, as your mechanical hard drive have OS files from previous. So after formatting those mechanical hard drives, just select the SSD drive which will show 233 gigs out of the 233 gigs, 100 MB will be for reserved for your system. So after selecting it, the OS file installation will be started and it will start copying and installing just like this. And it will take some time to finish the process, and whole process will be automatically. As soon as the installation finish of the OS files, and then just eject the DVD disk from your DVD drive or USB flash drive from the port. Then in some minutes your system will be ready, and now after final restart, Windows is ready to use. Yes, I can see the speed boost. Yes, I have installed Windows 10 64-bit on it. I don't know if you can notice it or not, but I can notice it. I can feel it. So after installation, you must install the Samsung Magician software, which you can get from Samsung website free of cost. Here is this PC, and under in it shows my whole SSD drive. You can see out of 250 gigs, only 232 is available or usable. Among of 232 gigs, I have only 203 gigs available to use after installing some number of utility softwares. And under hardware tab, it is also showing Samsung A4 860 250 GB SSD as listed with my old hard drive and DVD ROM. Okay, so this is the Samsung Magician software which I have already installed. You need to download and install that. So this is the interface. By this utility software, you can monitor your hard drive's health and can do benchmark tests, performance optimization, etc. So here you can see it is showing just connected to the SATA 3GPPS port, which is the highest from a motherboard, as said earlier. Now this is the benchmark test which I'm gonna start. So just click start. And after some random test, it shows that the result, which may takes up 2 minutes to perform. So as I have SATA 3GPPS, hence my sequential read speed is only 240 MB and write speed is 230 MB, and random read is 9277 IOPS and write speed is 17822 IOPS, which is max for my case, but can vary in overload mode. Okay, so don't consider this test as I have connected to SATA 3Gbps. I am using IDE mode, not using AACS mode. So when you will connect this device to your AAC mode without any mechanical hard drive or DVD-ROM and to SATA 6Gbps port, then I hope it will fly and like a just jet. And in my case, it has been huge speed difference, which I can notice. You know, and under this PC, it also shows the 100 Mbps space reserve drive on SSD, which you can see this 100 MB space reserve. Rest drives are my mechanical drives, which are just using as storage drives. So when you will edit a video, just transfer the files from your mechanical drive to SSD drive. That's it. By the way, it's a super popular based SSD drive right now in the market since last many years as it was. Don't hesitate to buy, just blindly go for it. And yes, it is really worth to buy with Samsung's 5 years of promise. So that's it, folks. Buy from below link to support my channel. Hit the like button, share this video, comment below if you have any query regarding this SSD, and let me know. Also, do subscribe my channel because I bring such video for you guys. So I hope to catch you soon. Take care, have a great time ahead. I was Sandeep Sundar, signing off. Bye guys.